So today I am going to explain you fiber to fabric. Okay, na? So this is the third chapter, okay, for class 6. Okay, standard 6, science, third chapter is there, okay, chemistry. See, we in our day-to-day life, we see variety of fibers. Okay. So there are some terms you should know what is this. Okay, what is yarn? Yarn is defined as a long, twisted, continuous strand composed of interlocked fibers or filaments which are used in knitting and weaving to form cloths. That is called as yarn. Okay, so these are actually long twisted fibers. Okay, na? And with the help of that, we are weaving the cloths. Okay, what is fiber then? Fiber is the main thread or filaments which form a yarn. It's called as fiber. So, fiber. Okay, if you just yarn is made up of fiber, fabric is made up of yarn. So this is the diagram you can remember. So smaller unit is what? A fiber. Bigger unit is yarn, and bigger biggest unit is what? Fabric. Am I clear? Okay. So where do these fiber come from? The question is from where these two? Where do fibers come from? So fibers are broadly classified into two broad categories. One is natural fiber, other is synthetic fiber. So natural fiber, as the name itself shows, that they are obtained in nature. Okay, like cotton is there. Synthetic fiber means what? They are man-made. Synthetic fibers is also called as artificial fiber. Am I clear? This is artificial fiber, man-made fiber or man-made fibers. Man-made fibers. So here we can see natural fibers, fibers that come from the plants and animals are found in nature are called as natural fiber. Example is there, we get jute and cotton from the plants. They are the natural fibers, yes or no? Silk fibers can be produced from the cocoon of silkworms. That is also a natural fiber. Okay, what about the synthetic fiber? Synthetic fibers are the made up of chemical substances. Substances not found directly in the nature are called as synthetic fiber. As I told you, they are man-made. Okay, or artificial fiber also we can say. Examples are there, nylon, acrylic, polyesters. Okay, so here is one table which distinguishes between the natural fiber and synthetic fiber. You should know. Okay, very important. They may ask you 3 marks question. Differentiate between natural fiber and synthetic fiber. So natural fibers are the fibers that are found in nature. Example, wool, okay, silk, cotton, etc. Whereas the synthetic fibers, these fibers are man-made or simply prepared in the lab. Example, nylon, okay, Teflon, etc. Okay, see, natural fibers, you will study all these in higher standards. What is Teflon, how it is made up of? Okay, what is nylon, how it is made up of? Okay, in higher standard. Now, just you have to remember the example of synthetic fiber. Nylon is there, Teflon is there. Okay, Bakelite. Switches, you know, na, electrical switches is made up of synthetic fiber. Okay, that is made up of Bakelite. Okay, Bakelite. B-A-K-E-L-I-T. Okay, see, second point, sir, natural fibers, they are good absorbents and so able to absorb heat, temperature, cold, sweat, okay, etc. Depending upon the conditions and nature of fibers. Okay, like cotton cloths, very useful. Okay, in a summer, correct or not? Similarly, that synthetic fibers, they do not have such pores as they are made up of chemicals. Na? So they do not act as a good adsorbents. Okay, as this is adsorbents. Okay. Absorbent also you can use absorbent. Absorbent. Okay, spelling this. Next, third point in natural fiber, no spinning process is required for filament production. In whereas in synthetic fibers, melting, weight or dry spinning process are used for filament production. Okay, next point in natural fibers, they are comfortable in use. Whereas synthetic fibers, they are not as comfortable as natural fibers. Okay, fifth point, their length is naturally obtained and it is not possible to change the fiber structures in natural fiber. Whereas in synthetic fiber, their lengths can be controlled by man and fibers can be made can easily be changed to different structures. Okay, so this difference is very, very important. Okay, so in the next part of the video, we'll continue the lesson. Thank you.